It is 8 a.m. on Sunday, March 17th, also known as St. Patrick's Day, and we have a long day planned ahead. Right now, we're on our way to a little college town called Waterloo to check out one of Canada's biggest parties.
Billy Ray was a preacher's son.
So this is our buddy Anthony. He lives here, so he's going to be showing us around. How much time do you think we have until we got to get going?
10 o'clock now, so probably 15, 20 minutes. Yeah, we should get going.
Ooh, which means we have time for beers.
I like the way you think. So Ezra Street, what happens there?
So Ezra is basically a giant block party that happens every year. Kind of started the first year that we were in university. We've been to it a couple times now. About 20,000-ish students, sometimes more, sometimes less, show up. There's tons of house parties going on. There's beer pong on the front lawns, people funneling off roofs. It's just an absolute giant, giant party.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah, it's absolutely insane.
We're on our way to Ezra. Woo! Woo!
You can hear it from like, how many blocks away are we?
Probably 3 blocks away.
From like 3 blocks away. You can just hear.
Well, that's because there's house parties going on.
There's house parties everywhere, apparently.
Look at that porch. That porch looks like it's about to collapse.
Give our party. This is sick. Looks like our people know their people.
We're going to get about 20,000 people here plus.
We're very excited to see that.
A couple more hours for it and then you'll get it. Says she tired, little money, need a big boy. Pull up 20-inch blades like I'm Lil' Troy. Now it's everybody flocking, need a decoy. Shorty mixing up the vodka with the liquor. G-Wagon, 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 G-Wagon. I pull it up. I got a lot of toys. 720S pumping Fallout Boy. You was talking shit in the beginning. I was feeling unforgiving. I know I pissed you off to see me winning. See the hit glue in my mouth and I be grinning. Yeah. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. 100 deep when I roll like the army. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying why.
I think some people over there are getting ticketed. I don't believe that no one on this street is drinking though. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. And your grandma more probably know me. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying wow. So it's like 1 p.m. right now. We're leaving Ezra. I think people are gonna be here till like 5. That's what Anthony said. But unfortunately, we gotta go because we're giving our friends in Toronto a little St. Patty's Day of their own. So since doing our first two events, we've learned a lot about what we can and can't do as a company. We can throw an amazing party and make a sweet video, but we can't pull hundreds of people or seem to make money.
We somehow managed to profit negative $3,300. We got very close to breaking even, but I'm getting a little frustrated that we keep losing money.
So Event is doing a bit of a 180. Instead of trying to fill these massive venues that we just can't afford and losing all this money, we're gonna be making smaller events. Like, oh, I don't know, throwing a St. Patty's Day party bus pub crawl. So it's about 5 o'clock and our bus is just getting here now. Bram and Chris are already at the pickup point with all of our friends, so we gotta go. Let's check this bus out. What's up, everybody? Hey guys, get your attention for 1 second. First of all, happy St. Patty's Day. We're going to 3 Irish bars today. You can leave your stuff on the bus between like 1 and 2. The last one is like the drop-off point, so if you leave your stuff on the bus, it's gone. Aside from that, let's get drunk! We just got to our first bar. It's a pub called O'Grady's. Let's go check it out. I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die,
I'ma touch the sky. Back when they thought pink polos, I hurt the rock. Before Cam got the shit to pop, the doors closed. I felt like Bad Boy Street Team. I couldn't work the locks. Now let's go. Take them back to the plan. Me and my mama hopped in that U-Haul van. Any pessimists, I ain't talk to them. Plus, I ain't had no phone in my apartment.
Our second stop was a pub called Brazen Head. It gets pretty rowdy and has decently priced beer, so what's not to like?
Return to the Mac. Get on what it is, what it does, what it is, what it isn't. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Me get up. First shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby's for the game. Nope, nope, y'all can't copy yet. Blah.
Love isn't the best place to find the lovers, so the bar is where I go. Me and my friends sat at the table doing shots, tripping fast, and then we talk slow. So now I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead.
The last bar for the night is one of my favorites in Toronto. It's called Dublin Calling, and it is always a party. You are my treasure. Yeah, you.
Give me your attention, baby. Tell you a little something about yourself. You're one of those flawless. Ooh, you a sexy lady. But you walk around here like you wanna be someone else. Oh, whoa. I know that you don't know it, but you're fine, so fine. Fine, so fine. Oh, whoa. Oh, girl, I'm gonna show you when you're mine. Oh, mine. Mine, oh, mine. Treasure.
We're on our way home right now, and tonight was sick. There's so many good things. First of all, I had the most fun I've ever had in any adventure event because I wasn't working the entire time. I got to like actually enjoy myself, which is amazing. But best of all, how we did financially, drum roll please. We didn't lose money.
Woo!
Woo!
Yeah.
Woo!
Cheers to not being broke.
We're actually up like $60, which might not sound like much. We didn't lose thousands, which is incredible. And so, as per typical Avenge fashion, we will be donating 80% of proceeds, which is what, like $48, to the charity, the Covenant House, which is a Toronto charity that helps support the homeless. And best of all, most importantly, this means that we're like a viable business now. We are, I guess you could say, I don't think it really makes any sense, a profitable nonprofit. And we just made $12.
I have someone who needs me. Someone I've needed so long. For once unafraid.